Hey everyone, this is part 23 of my Chaos run of the Final Fantasy V Four Job Fiesta 2022 with the modifiers No 750 and Berserker Risk. So in the last part was a bit of a fiasco. I first tried to go through the Fork Tower and wasn't able to pull off the little trick I needed to be able to defeat one of the two bosses. And then I gave up and went to the final dungeon and, well, if you watch that, you know what I'm talking about. It didn't go so well. I just managed to defeat the first boss out of many and then had to run out with the tail between my legs because I was about to run out of high potions, basically, if I had proceeded any further. But, in this part, I'm going to actually try Fork Tower again. I have actually tested the whole method a little bit, and I have confirmed that it does work. However, what happened when I tried it before is that I was doing zero damage to myself, and it seems, through my testing, that if you do zero damage, the proc never happens. It never procs. So, I've tested it for a while myself here, and it seems pretty clear, anyway. And as soon as I removed my shields and lowered my defense, and I started doing a little bit damage to myself, the proc started working like they should. So the tactic should work. Anyway, it's set up here for the tower. I'm going to go with the same party setup as I did the first time through here. First attempt, I mean, in the previous video. No, like that. So, Kryl will attempt to reflect the silence proc from the Maze Masher onto the boss, and Ferris will try to kill the boss. Need to be in front row, I think. And going to remove the shield right away. Ferris can still have her shield, doesn't really matter though. So, Maze Master, Reflect Ring, Holy Lance, Reflect Ring, no shield on Kryl. Lena and Bards are set up the way they should be. Yeah, that should be good. Let's go. So Bards and Lena goes right to the physical tower, and Kryl and Ferris goes to the left tower, the magic tower. Just run away. I've also learned that it seems that in the Pixel Remaster, this version I mean, the Almagest ability or spell, which is an attack that the final boss uses, pierces shell apparently in this version. So there's no way to reduce the damage. the only way to in any way reduce or negate damage is by using the Aegis shield, which has a chance of blocking it completely. And that means, well, I can't get the shell status, so I think. So I will have to have enough HP to survive the full blast of Almagest with every all characters. I said I couldn't get shell status, but I mean, it doesn't really matter. As I said, it pierces shell apparently in this version, so I have no choice but to gain a few levels before I get to the final boss in order to have a slightly higher HP. I can't remember how much damage it will actually do, or if it's less changed even, maybe, from the previous versions, if it's the same or not. So. I think I'll need at least like 1700, 1800 HP, maybe? To be sure of survival. Maybe that's not enough even. I have also pretty much decided to power up the chicken knife. Well, I'm escaping now, but I'm not doing that just for the chicken knife. I just can't be bothered fighting these enemies because I can't use magic and they'll counter with nasty things if I attack them physically. But yeah, I'm escaping. I will be escaping more, grinding up the chicken knife power, so to speak, as well, I think. I may just go through the Great Sea Trench, just escape from every battle, just to get some extra power to the chicken knife and get some treasures on the way. I mean, you can do that anywhere really, just escape from battles, of course, but it's a bit dull doing it and just walking around the same place over and over. So I can do at least parts of it by actually traversing some dungeon. Probably a little more, bit more fun or engaging. Okay, I may actually get a game over here. Oh, I managed to escape. I think if they removed both party members, it's a game over. So that wouldn't be good. Managed to win a fight without even trying. Okay. Go bards. Right, time for the real boss fight, or, well, the other one anyway. Go. Hope it hits. Yes. And return doesn't work. Nice. So yeah, just attack yourself with the Maze Masher and hope for the silence effect to reflect onto the boss. And then immediately, well, wait for it to actually work, it worked, and then you attack. And don't attack more than once after, because it runs out really fast. I think it's almost, I think it probably have already run out by the time it's my turn again. Silas himself. That's not good. Thank you. what it was trying to do. It says no effect. Silence missed, so I have to be careful about that so you don't attack. Yeah, this fight can take a long time. Depends on how much damage you're able to do per turn with your with the character that's actually doing any damage. It's also a good thing if he keeps casting like spells that can be reflected back onto himself and do damage to himself as well, of course. That's great. Third in a row that missed. Fourth. There we go. I think I mentioned this the first time I tried this in the previous part, that once he reaches a certain HP threshold, he will start using more powerful spells. And then it's just a matter of time, he will basically kill himself without your help. He stopped himself. Nice. Doesn't last quite long though, unfortunately. Ooh, haste. stop missing, please? Maybe he's silenced when it has no effect when he tries to use spells. That maybe it lasts longer than I think. But I mean, it's risky to try to attack several times. One mistake and yeah, it's probably still silenced there. One mistake and he resets the battle to the beginning and you have to start over from scratch, so yeah. Come on. you. Yay. Come on. Damn it. That's not nice of you. Drain. Cute. Two in a row, amazing. Wonder how much HP he has now. thank you for the regen. Nice. Another attack. Oops. Ooh. He couldn't use drain because it was still silenced. That's good. Silence himself. There we go, now he's past the threshold of starting to use the tier 3 elemental spells. So I may as well just sit here and watch now actually. Should work. Don't just cast Thundaga, Fireaga, Blizzaga on himself. Have to be patient in this battle, and of course you need to be able to do, I'd say, at least 500 damage with your damage dealer per turn when he's silenced. The more the better, of course. Reflected flare. There we go. Right, time to restore my equipment here. Hermit sandals and partisan and crystal shield. Okay, let's go say hello to Sid. Yay, now I've got a submarine. And I'm going to the Istri Falls next. Just to stock up on items here. And sleep, I guess. Not that I need to, I think you can rest in the submarine, right? I think so. Chicken knife at, by the way. 35. And max is 127. So that means 164 battles. It powers up. Attack, it goes up by one for every two battles you run away from, so. But yeah, next thing on the line is to go to the Istri Falls and contemplating going to the Great Trench, even though there's nothing there I actually need. But just to go there, collect the treasures, escape from battles, I think. Maybe not, we'll see. But there's Istri Falls anyway, for sure. I want the Aegis Shield. So let's save here on third slot. And that's it for part 23 then. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.